Thanks, Lucas, for the introduction. I want to also thank Lucas and Jaime for the invitation. Hi, folks. In this talk, I will speak about geometric flows on hypersurface in the space forms, and I will present some applications. First, I will make a brief introduction. After, I will apply support function flow to solve some problems. And in the final, I will present some open problems that I think we can use geometric flows to solve. In this presentation, we will consider a closed, orientable, and connected hypersurface sigma in a Riemannian manifold M. The shape operator is given like that, where D is the Levi-typical connection of M, and G is the outward unit normal vector to sigma. Associated with this shape operator, we have the normalized K-Esman mean curvature of sigma, given like that, where K is at N minus 1, and sigma K is the K-Esman elementary symmetric function of the principal curvature vector lambda. The following definition will be important to the next results. We say sigma is K convex if the elementary symmetric function is greater or equal to 0 for I up to K. Sigma is convex if the elementary symmetric function is greater or equal to 0 for I up to N minus 1. And sigma is strictly convex if the symmetric elementary function is positive for I up to N minus 1. We say the hypersurface sigma is star-shaped if it can be written as a graph of a geodesic sphere centered at the origin. Let psi zero be a closed isometric immersed oriented hypersurface. We consider a one-parameter family of isometric immersed hypersurface satisfying this initial value problem here, where x is the outward unit normal to this hypersurface, and the f is the general speed function. Here are some examples of geometric flows. The first one is the mean curvature flow. The second one is the inverse mean curvature flow. The next one is the support function flow. F is given by minus u, where u is the inner product between the gradient of v and the unit vector x, with v as the hyperbolic cosine function when the ambient space is the hyperbolic space. The last example is Brendel-Guan-Lis flow. F is given like that when the ambient space is the hyperbolic space. I think geometric flows are like these two box. Let me explain. When I have a problem in my house, I come here and I choose the sweet table 2 to solve my problem. When I have a math problems, I think these two here in these two box are like the geometric flows. So I choose a sweet table flow to solve my problem. Here are some applications of curvature flows in the proof of the geometric inequalities. In 2020, Andrews, Wu, and Lee used the mean curvature flow to prove out a Heisenkaiser type inequality for hypersurface with positive heat curvature in hyperbolic space. In 2017, Girão and Dai use the inverse mean curvature flow to prove Alexandrov-Fenchel type inequality for hypersurface in the sphere. Now I will explain for you the motivation that led us to get a counterexample for a conjecture made by Zhe Wang and Du. After, I will explain how we use the support function flow to get this counterexample. In this part, the mean Parents I will use is the joint work with Girão, Pinheiro and Rodrigues, published in 2021. Alexandrov proved that let sigma be a convex hypersurface in Euclidean space, then the integrals of K curvature and K minus 1 curvature are related by this inner quadrilia, where omega n minus 1 is the area of the unit sphere. Their quality holds if and only if sigma is a round sphere. In 2009, Guan Li used the inverse mean curvature flow to prove Alexandrov-Fenchel inner quadrilia still holds for n sigma, which is star-shaped and k-convex, that is, they change convex hypothesis by the k-convex hypothesis and star-shaped, and they proved this inner quadrilia still holds. In 2011, Lan used the k equal 1 case of Alexandrov-Fenchel inequalities, that is, this inequality here, where norm of sigma is the area of sigma, to prove the Penrose inequality for graphs. In 2014, Zhe Wang Yu used the cases of Alexandrov-Fenchel inequalities, for which k is old, to establish for graphs versions of the Penrose inequality in the context of the Gauss-Bundeschein mass. In 2013, Dowd, Quarto and Sakovi showed that to prove a Penrose type inequalities for asymptotic hyperbolic graph, it was necessary to prove this result here, which says if sigma is a star-shaped with mean curvature greater than zero, then it holds this inequality here, which this inequality relates this integral of the mean curvature with the wave function and the powers of the area of the hypersurface and the area of the sphere. That quality holds if and only if a sigma is a geodesic sphere centered at the origin. So this result was proved by de Lima and Girão in 2016. We say a hypersurface sigma in hyperbolic space is holospheric convex or H-convex if all principal curvatures are greater or equal 1 for I up to n minus 1. Equivalently, for Hx in sigma, there is a holosphere enclosed sigma at x. In 2015, Zhe Wang and Yu proved that if sigma is a H-convex hypersurface in hyperbolic space, so we have a general weighted Alexandrov-Fenchel inequality for odd k. That quality holds if and only if sigma is a geodesic sphere centered at the origin. They use this inequality here to prove the Penrose inequality for asymptotically hyperbolic graphs. To prove this theorem here, they use an induction argument from J to J plus 2, with the base case being the inequality proved by de Lima and Girão, that is. So, this inequality here, okay? So, in the same work, they conjecture this result here, which says if sigma is a H-convex hypersurface in hyperbolic space, so we have this inequality for even K. The equality holds if and only if sigma is a geodesic sphere centered at the origin. They remarked that Then Dutch argument from J to J plus 2 still works in this case. So it, the initial case, k equals 0, that is, if sigma is a H-convex hypersurface in hyperbolic space, then we have this inequality here that relates the integral of the wave function and the powers of the area of the hypersurface over the area of the sphere. The equality holds if and only if sigma is a geodesic sphere centered at the origin. So this conjecture here was then the only thing left in order to prove this conjecture here. So my colleagues and I started to try to prove this inequality here. We show this inequality is not true, that is, we show there exists a H-convex hypersurface sigma in hyperbolic space, such that the opposite inequality holds. So, we know about this counterexample. We can ask that if this inequality here still holds for k greater than 0, for even k greater than 0. The answer is yes. This inequality here will hold for even k greater than 0. O Li and Diel proved if sigma is a H-convex hypersurface in hyperbolic space, we have the inequality for even k greater than 0. The equality holds if and only if sigma is a geodesic sphere centered at the origin. To prove this result here, they use Brandebourg-Lee's law. So let me go back to the examples I showed for you before in the introduction. So all these examples here are used in a proof of some result in my presentation. With this inequality here, no, with this result here, all cases of this inequality were proved for a H-convex hypothesis. So now I will present for you some concepts that will be important to understand our mean results in our work. We consider the hyperbolic space to be ambient space with the Poincaré-Ball model given by this ball here, and our with this map here, where the Euclidean norm is denoted like that, and del denotes the Euclidean metric. In this model, the function v has this expression here. Let I0 be a closed isometric method oriented hypersurface. We consider a one-parameter family of isometric immersed hypersurface satisfying this initial value problem, where x is the outer unit norm to this hypersurface, and f is a general speed function. So in our work, we work with this support function, so that sigma involves according to the support function flow. The first thing we try to do is to show this flow here exists for all time. Now I will present for you the idea to prove this proposition here. So we consider for each t in this interval, the hypersurface phi t defined by this expression here. Note that if phi is defined by this this expression here, then it's satisfying this differential equation. So we show that this flow here and this support function flow, this flow here, are up to reparametrization the same flow. So since this flow here exists for all time, the support function flow will exist for all time. Here finish the idea to prove the proposition. So now I will define two quantities. The first one is for a hypersurface sigma in a hyperbolic space. We define the quantity P sigma by this expression here. For a Euclidean hypersurface sigma, we define the quantity Q sigma by this expression here, where norm of sigma delta and d sigma delta are the area and the area element of sigma with respect to the metric induced by the Euclidean metric. I want to ask for you to pay attention in these two quantities here, because the relation between these two quantities will be very important to show some results in our work. Along the flow, this flow here, the quantity P satisfying this inequality, furthermore, the equality holds at T if and only if sigma T is a geodesic sphere centered at the origin. So now I will explain for you the idea to get a counterexample. That is, there exists a H-convex hypersurface sigma in hyperbolic space such that inequality holds. First, we use Girão and Rodrigue results proved in 2020. That is, there exists a strictly convex hypersurface sigma delta in Euclidean space such that this inequality here holds. This is the hypersurface they found. So by the scale variance of Q, we can assume this hypersurface here is in the ball. So we consider sigma t defined by this expression here, where sigma zero is the sigma delta when seen as a hypersurface in hyperbolic space. Now we use this relation between the two quantities, that is, the limit of p when t goes to infinity is equal q applied in sigma delta. So use the inequality proved by Girão and Rodrigues, we get this inequality here, that there is this t0 in this interval, for which this inequality here holds, for it t greater or equal to zero. To finish the proof, we will use this proposition, what says if psi zero is such that as a Euclidean hypersurface sigma is strictly convex, then there exists t in this interval for which phi t given by this expression here is h convex for h t satisfying this inequality here. So this proposition here guarantees that we can choose t zero such that sigma t will be h convex for h t greater or equal t zero. Here finish the idea to get a counterexample. The following result I will show for you is this, which says if sigma is a star-shaped hypersurface in hyperbolic space satisfying this inequality here, then we get a inequality very similar to the inequality conjecture by J. Wang and Yu. We see reappear this constant, and in the inequality conjecture by them don't appear. Let me go back for you remember. Here, you don't see that constant. Now, I will show for you the idea to prove this theorem. First, we use this proposition, which says, if let's say B so that as a hypersurface in hyperbolic space, its mean curvature is greater or equal 1, then as a Euclidean hypersurface, sigma has the mean curvature greater than 0. So we note that our hypersurface in hyperbolic space has the property to its mean curvature is greater or equal 1. So we get sigma as a Euclidean hypersurface. Sigma has this property here. So we can use Girão and Rodrigues results proved in 2020, which says if sigma is star-shaped and its mean curvature is greater than 0, then we have this inequality, that is, this quantity here will be greater than this constant. So we consider sigma t defined by this expression. Then we use again the relation between these two quantities here. We use also this, the fact of this constant here, this quantity P is not increased along this flow here. So using the result proved by Girão and Rodrigues and this relation between these two quantities together with this fact here, we get this inequality. So here write this inequality here, we get the inequality asked in the theory here. So if you know about this inequality here, a natural question arises. Let me go to the question. This question here. What are the largest constant lambda for which the inequality? This inequality here holds for any hypersurface sigma in hyperbolic space satisfies some reasonable convexity assumption. Our method shows that this inequality here holds for any, if this inequality here holds for any sigma which as Euclidean hypersurface is star-shaped and its mean curvature is positive, then the inequality in the theory for any sigma in hyperbolic space, satisfying this inequality here, will hold. If you consider this constant here as in the previous remarks, so we have lambda 2 will be in this interval by the two last fields. If n is equal to, we show this constant lambda 1 will be equal to pi squared over 54 when sigma is a hypersurface in hyperbolic space with the geodesic curvature of sigma satisfying this inequality here. Here are our last result. Which says if sigma is a H-convex hypersurface in hyperbolic space and K is in this set is even, then we get a inequality very similar to the inequality proved by Wu, Li, and Yale. To prove this theorem here, we use an induction argument from J to J plus 2. with the base case being the inequality proved in the theory before, that is, this inequality here, we use to be a base case. So now I will present for you some problems. In my presentation, we saw a lot of Alexander Fischer inequalities with weight function. Now, the first problem I will present for you is Alexander Fischer inequality without function. So, without weight function. So, here are some concepts that will be important to understand the first problem. We say a hypersurface sigma in hyperbolic space has a non-negative sectional curvature if the product between the principal curvatures are greater or equal 1. The Gauss-Bonnet curvature of the induced metric of the hypersurface sigma in hyperbolic space can be expressed by this. In 2019, Wu and Li used the inverse mean curvature flow to prove this Sobolev type inequality for any hypersurface sigma with non-negative sectional curvature in hyperbolic space. The equality holds if and only if sigma is a geodesic sphere in hyperbolic space. So they applied this theorem here to get Alexandrov-Fenchel inequality without weight for any hypersurface sigma with non-negative sectional curvature in hyperbolic space. The equality holds if and only if sigma is a geodesic sphere in hyperbolic space. So in 2014, this Sobolev type inequality and this Alexandrov-Fenchel inequality without weight function was proved by Zheng Wang and Yu for H-convex hypersurface in hyperbolic space. Motivated by this result here, they left this conjecture for an odd case, that is, any hypersurface sigma with non-negative sectional curvature in hyperbolic space satisfying this inequality. The equality holds if and only if sigma is a geodesic sphere in hyperbolic space. For k equals 0, this inequality was proved by Zheng Wang and Yu for H-convex hypersurface. For a general integer k, this inequality here was proved by Wang and Xie under a stronger condition that sigma is H-convex. So, this conjecture is the first problem I will left for us to try. And I ask for you to pay attention to these two remarks here, because they will be important to understand the next problem. So I show for you this result proved by Zheng Wang and Yu, which says if sigma is a H-convex hypersurface in hyperbolic space, so we have this inequality for OK, the equality holds if and only if sigma is a geodesic sphere centered at the origin. The next problem I will left for us to try is to try to improve this result here by changing H-convex hypothesis to the non-negative sectional curvature hypothesis. Zheng Wang and Yu, when they proved this result here, they use this H-convex hypothesis only tipo vezes na quadrilha, only to when they apply de vezes na quadrilha, tipo vezes feeling here, and when they apply the verb feeling here to prove a verb na quadrilha, ok? Which verb feeling here say that if k is less than n minus 1, nh convex hypersurface in hyperbolic space satisfying verb na quadrilha. So I think we can use the same idea used by Zhewang and Diu. So you need to prove this conjecture here and prove this theorem here for a non-negative this condition here, non-negative section curvature. Replace this hypothesis here for a non, sorry, replace this hypothesis here for a non-negative section curvature. Okay? So that was my talk I prepared for you. Thank you for your attention.